Hello, everyone. I'm Anusha, a senior analytics SA at AWS. Today, I'm going to present an analytics session in 15 minutes with a focus on how to build a data warehouse with zero infrastructure management. Infrastructure management for traditional data warehouses can be a challenge for several reasons. Data warehouses are complex systems with multiple components, such as servers, storage, and databases. These systems require management and maintenance. Performance and scalability are critical for data warehouses, and they often go hand in hand. Data warehouses must scale up as the data grows without compromising on performance. They should also provide consistent performance during peak hours, irrespective of user load. In traditional data warehouses, this requires ongoing tuning and optimization of the infrastructure. Next challenge is security. Security is paramount as businesses store critical information in data warehouses. To maintain high security means requiring ongoing management of security policies and procedures, such as hardware compliance, data encryption, and more. With these challenges, often the costs increase to handle ongoing management, maintenance, and staffing. Amazon Redshift Serverless addresses these challenges and makes it easy to run and scale analytics without having to manage data warehouse infrastructure. For those of you who don't know Redshift, it's a data warehouse service that AWS offers. With Serverless Redshift, you as a business user don't have to make decisions on what kind of compute or how much compute you may need. Redshift Serverless automatically and intelligently provisions the compute based on your user's queries. It automatically takes care of infrastructure management through several features such as automatic scaling, automatic patching, automatic workload management, automatic table optimization and tuning, and more. As a result, you'll experience high performance consistently, even during periods of peak load. For resiliency, advanced monitoring, backup and recovery are automatically done. Redshift Serverless provides best-in-class security and industry compliance. Since this is a serverless solution, you only pay for when you're using the service. When you're not executing queries or running jobs, the compute automatically suspends and you don't pay anything. You can also set your own spending limits so that Redshift doesn't scale beyond what you choose to pay for. If you are an existing Redshift customer and you want to move to Redshift Serverless, you can do the transition with no code modifications. In addition to serverless, you may be aware that Redshift offers provision mode as well. You have the flexibility and the choice. There are many users who want to start their new analytics workloads very quickly and will use serverless. But for those who want granular controls and create custom provisioned environments, they can always use provision clusters. Data warehouses usually require various maintenance jobs to get optimal performance. Redshift has made this automatic to users in order to give them ease of use. Our goal is to automate as many tasks as possible. Redshift automatically does table optimization so that your queries perform better. The feature is called Automatic Table Optimization, or ATO. It analyzes your queries and selects the best sort and distribution keys to determine the optimal physical layout of your data. ATO can modify column compression encodings as well to achieve high performance and reduce the storage utilization. Redshift automatically does workload management to provide high performance irrespective of user load. Dashboard optimization is also done automatically by creating materialized views intelligently for complex queries. These automated materialized views are completely managed by Redshift. You can continue to query base tables, and Redshift automatically rewrites your queries to use materialized views if one exists. Next, moving on to some architectural patterns. Centralized monolithic architectures can be complex and difficult to scale across business units. Data mesh architectures, on the other hand, scale well and encourage data-driven agility by supporting the sharing of data products. Using data sharing feature in Redshift, you can build scalable data mesh architectures. Here, I'm presenting two examples. In the first, you logically split your data based on organization, business unit, or any other entity that is applicable for your business, and perform data sharing among them with centralized governance. This enables each department to scale separately without affecting others and still have a comprehensive view of the entire data set through data sharing. As you can see, you can create a data mesh using a combination of provisioned and serverless Redshift. In the second architecture, separation is based on workload type. With each workload being fully isolated from the other, it reduces impact and enhances scalability. Now, how do we get data into Redshift? We have introduced new simple low-code ingestion options. Today, I'm going to talk about two of them. First is autocopy from Amazon S3. Using this feature, data from Amazon S3 data lake is ingested continuously into Redshift in near real time. As new data continuously lands in specified folders, ingestion process is triggered automatically. This feature keeps track of loaded files and automatically excludes already ingested files from the pipeline. All file formats supported by the familiar Redshift copy command, including CSV, JSON, Parquet, Avro, are all supported for autocopy as well. Next is streaming ingestion. Data warehouses often receive data from streaming sources such as Kinesis data streams or Kafka. Loading streaming data to Redshift is made easy through streaming ingestion feature. I'll talk more about it when I show a demo. Next, I'm going to dive into the demo. I'll show you how to get started with Redshift serverless in just 4 clicks. Before we begin, let me introduce you to some Redshift serverless terminology that I'll be using. A workgroup is a collection of compute resources. A namespace represents storage. And Redshift processing units, or RPUs, are a measure of compute power in Redshift serverless. RPUs are represented as a simple number. If you need more compute, you increase the number of RPUs. Now let's get started with the demo. What you're seeing is Amazon Redshift Management Console. To access Redshift serverless, you can just use the link here. You can see that there are some pre-created namespaces and workgroups. To create a workgroup, just click Create Workgroup, give it a name, verify the defaults for network and security, and choose a base RPU configuration. The default is 128. If you want to start with lesser capacity, you can choose a lower number. If you want more compute, you can choose a higher number. And then click Next. Your namespace a name. The IAM role is automatically created for you. And data is automatically encrypted as well. Click Next. In this screen, review your options. And then finally click Create. The serverless namespace and workgroup will be available within a few minutes for you. If you're an existing Redshift provision cluster user, and if you want to move to Redshift serverless, you can restore a snapshot into Redshift serverless. In order to do that, go to Provision Clusters dashboard, and then navigate to Snapshots. Choose the snapshot that you would like to restore to serverless, and click Restore to Serverless Namespace. Choose the namespace that you want to restore to, and then click Restore. Your provision cluster will be available in serverless within a few minutes after the restore process. To access Redshift serverless, you have different ways. You can use JDBC, ODBC drivers, you can use Data API, and more. Query Editor V2 is a simple web-based tool that makes accessing Redshift serverless easy. So to access Query Editor V2, just click on the link here. I'll be using Analytics in 15 serverless workgroup. Double click to connect to it. Now that you are connected to the workgroup, you can do loads and queries based on your user requirements. I would like to load supplier data into Redshift, so I've created a table called supplier. Once the table is created, data from S3 can be loaded using a copy command. I'll run the copy command to load million records that are available in S3 into Redshift supplier table. You can also choose to query the data directly from S3 if you have it cataloged. The data is loaded. You can write queries on this table. For example, I would do a simple count to get the supplier count. As you can see, there are a million rows in supplier table. If your source is a streaming source, such as Kinesis or Managed Streaming Kafka, MSK, you can access them using external schema. In this demo, I would be using Kinesis data streams. To access data from Kinesis data streams, first step is to create an external schema. And in the create external schema, you just give the name to the schema and provide an IAM authorization. After the external schema is created, you can create materialized views by referring to the external schema dot the stream name. I have a Kinesis data stream with the name customer order line item stream. I can refer to the stream just by using external schema dot the stream name notation. I'll run these statements to drop and recreate the materialized view. The materialized view is now created. To load data from stream to Redshift, you would just refresh the materialized view. Once the refresh is complete, you can start querying the data. The refresh is now complete. I'll run a simple count query to get the number of records from the stream. 4,000 records from the Kinesis data stream got loaded into Redshift. Let's view the first 10 records. As you can see, the data is loaded in JSON format, and individual attributes can be queried using dot notation using particle. I'm running this command, and you can see individual attributes from the data shown here. Now I'll load some additional data into the stream. For that, I'll use Kinesis Data Generator, which is a tool that can produce sample data. To the customer order line item stream, I'll send some data. I'll send some 500 records and then stop the stream. So I think I sent 400. I'll go back and refresh the materialized view. Once the materialized view is refreshed, you would be able to see newly sent records in the materialized view. The refresh is complete. Now, if I do a count on the stream, the count was previously 4,000. Now, the 400 records that I newly sent are reflected here. That's the demo on serverless. Many customers have started using serverless already, and they have shared a few quotes to express how their experience with serverless has been. Roche quoted how serverless helped them complete data management without cluster management, which in turn optimized cost by provisioning right capacity to meet their demands. NextGen shared how moving to Redshift serverless reduced manual interventions in managing their data warehouse. They also shared that their performance improved while cost reduced. If you're interested in reading these quotes, please pause the video for a while, take a quick read, and move on. We are offering $300 in free credits to try Redshift serverless. Please go ahead and try it today yourself and let us know your experience. To enable more customers to get started on Redshift serverless, we are introducing a low base RPU configuration that you can start from. You can start now with as low as 8 RPUs as your base configuration. That brings me to the end of my talk. You can refer to the materials given here to know more about Redshift serverless. It was a pleasure talking to you today. Thank you and have a great day.